I might be biased, but from my perspective, the magnetometer is the most important instrument on the spacecraft. And it's important particularly to resolve the characteristics of the ocean. So whenever you see spacecraft with very long booms, the instruments we build are on those booms. And so what it does is it measures the magnetic field, and if we focus only on Ganymede, which is going to be our main focus, it's going to measure the internal dynamo field at Ganymede. Ganymede is the only moon in the solar system that has an internal dynamo field, and we want to try and understand why. We're going to be able to model that. It's going to measure the environment around Ganymede. But the most difficult measurement it's going to make is it's going to measure very small magnetic fields that are generated by electrical currents flowing in the liquid water ocean at Ganymede. We think there's a liquid water ocean, and we want to confirm it. Is going to be focusing on three of Jupiter's moons, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto.
The main thing we know about them, the most exciting thing, is we expect and we have evidence that underneath the icy surfaces of these moons, the water has melted to produce oceans. And maybe the most fascinating thing, or sort of shocking thing, is how much water there could be. At Ganymede, there might be, or we expect there is, about 25 times as much water as there is in all of our oceans combined. We want to understand how thick the ice shell is on top of the water. It's not like the Arctic, where it's, you know, maybe a meter. This is kilometers, but then there's a very big ocean underneath. We want to understand what it's made of, so how conductive it is and what might be inside the water making it electrically conductive. And also we want to know how deep it goes.
The environment at Jupiter is very extreme. There's a very high level of radiation. Also, it's extremely cold. We've got to operate the sensors down to temperatures below minus 150 degrees. The other challenge is the magnetic field of Ganymede is so twisted, we had to develop a new sensor, an optical scalar sensor, to complement the vector sensors that we fly on the spacecraft. It's going to take about 8 years to get to Jupiter, and will be switched on every so often along the way, approximately every 6 months. There will be three flybys of the Earth, and we will be switched on for those. And there's also a couple of other flybys past Venus and potentially some asteroids where we may switch on as well.